Hi, I'm Brett, and this is COVID-19 Explained for Nova Scotians. We're back at it again this week, answering more of your COVID-19 questions. But before we get into it, a little bit about me. I'm a second-year Dalhousie medical student, and I'm planning to pursue a career in either surgery or emergency medicine. Luckily, I still have some time to figure that out. Okay, let's jump right in. So what is contact tracing? When someone tests positive, public health begins a case investigation to try and determine how the individual got the virus and who they may have passed it on to. These people have a higher risk of becoming infected and spreading the virus to others. A close contact is defined as someone who has been within 2 meters of an infected person. By 2 meters, we don't just mean by passing someone at the grocery store. You must have spent some prolonged time together. This could include caring for the individual who is sick or having been exposed to bodily fluids. Now, when we say bodily fluids, we are referring to airborne droplets from breathing and or coughing. This is why masks are so important. After a person is identified with a case of COVID-19, public health contacts the person on the phone. These are non-judgmental conversations about travel history, who they live with, where they work, and what gatherings they attended over the 14-day exposure period. After receiving this information, public health can then create a list of locations where the person may have transmitted COVID-19. Each new contact public health identifies will also get a phone call letting them know they've been potentially exposed. Those contacts go through a risk assessment and the nurses arrange for them to be tested. Remember from last week's episode with my colleague Mike, if you have been in an exposure site, book a test online. Remember, keeping social circles small helps slow the spread. How can you find out if you've been exposed to COVID-19? First, exposure notices. These are shared online. Exposure alerts are issued when someone who has tested positive for COVID-19 confirms they have been at a location. Second, you hear directly from public health. Public health will notify you under the following circumstances. 1. You are a close contact of someone who has tested positive for COVID-19. 2. If your child is listed as a close contact of someone who has tested positive for COVID-19, in this situation, public health will provide further information on isolation and testing. Finally, we have the COVID Alert app. It's designed to note when two users spend at least 15 minutes less than 2 meters apart. If a user later tests positive for COVID-19, they can use the app to anonymously notify contacts of potential exposure. This week, before we sign off, we want to remind people to get asymptomatic testing. If you have no symptoms and are in HRM, you can get a walk-in test at the Zatzman Sportsplex in Dartmouth until the 13th of December. The rest of the province can book asymptomatic tests online using the COVID-19 self-assessment tool. Testing asymptomatic individuals will help us further determine the extent of community spread in Nova Scotia, or hopefully, lack thereof. I wanted to take this opportunity to say thank you to all Nova Scotians on behalf of Dalhousie Medical School. We want to thank all Nova Scotians for stepping up and doing their job to help turn the tide. With the holidays around the corner, it's more important than ever that we continue to wash our hands, wear our masks, and keep our social circles small. Again, on behalf of Dalhousie Medical School, we want to thank all Nova Scotians and wish you and your family a happy holidays. That's COVID-19 Explained for this week. Check back soon to learn more.